Greetings, everybody. Jill and Rob back with you again here for a little tripping with Truesdales, as I think we're going to start calling it. Jill and I were talking about trying to develop a hashtag on the way up here. We're in Myrtle Beach right now, Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. We were talking about developing a hashtag for our travels whenever we go off to somewhere, because gosh knows we never seem to stay at home anymore. But at any rate, we're in Myrtle Beach here this weekend. Jill is the reigning queen of freebies when it comes to birthday stuff.
Woohoo!
She got herself onto a mailing list with the people at Medieval Times, which anybody who knows us knows that we frequent Medieval Times. We seem to be here at least once a year. We come during our annual vacation to Myrtle Beach, but because of the fact that she got a entry on that mailing list that I mentioned there, she got a free ticket for her birthday. So we're going to take advantage of that since we have the opportunity here. I will point out that I am jealous because of the fact that I also put myself on the mailing list, or thought I did, but I have yet to receive my free voucher, and my birthday was in July. It's now middle of September. So, case as it is, we're going to go to Medieval Times here this evening, and we wanted to show off the experience of what it is to go to Medieval Times. It's one of those things to where I don't know that a lot of people go to it because some people might think it's cheesy or whatever else, but we enjoy it. We go, like I say, at least once a year. We enjoy the experience of eating there and watching the show. It's always entertaining, always a lot of fun. But just wanted to give people a sense of what it's like to go through the, you know, the entryway and whatnot and see what all is there. So we'll be taking you through the entire process. We'll probably get you in the front door there and show you the ticketing process too. It's pretty straightforward, but they've got a lot of gimmicks in there, a lot of things where you could potentially drop, oh gosh, if you had a family of three or four, you could probably drop as much as $200 in there if you wanted to, between specialty drinks and pictures and everything else. The tickets themselves are pretty expensive. They're about $40 or $50 for one person. That's the base ticket as well. You could add things on to it if you wanted to, like they have a royalty package to where you get preferred seating and a cheering banner and all this other stuff, but the fact of the matter is there really is not a bad seat in that arena. We've been to several of their castles here now, and the seating is pretty much all the same. There is, like I say, not a bad seat in the house. It's actually, to me, a little bit better if you get there later because you can sit up higher and have a better vantage point than you would from sitting down low. But yeah, it's a fun little outing that we enjoy here, and we're looking forward to giving everybody a view of what it is to be a lord or lady of the realm here at Medieval Times in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. So we'll be back in a little bit with some more information and some more inside stuff. Stay tuned. Smells good out here.
Ticket for me my
birthday, but I need to purchase one
for him. Aww.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks,
thank
enjoy.
You.
Alright, can you notice? Thank you. Do you want a picture or no?
Might as well take it. You get a crown? Thank you.
There we are. Perfect.
We're in the front here, ready. 1, 2, and 3.
What's your table number?
All right, let's see. Here on the wall.
One of your necklaces, please. Who are they?
Hello, how are you?
I'm doing well, thank you.
Back. Here's the guy's back.
Senator, congratulations to you and wish you the happiest of 14 birthdays. Another cheer for me, my friends. Hip hip! Next year, man, let's give me some for Rune Paul. Hooray! Hello, Rune. Have a seat on the stool, my lord, and face his majesty. And have a seat on the stool. Sit on the stool. Put your backside on the stool. There you go. There's a good lad. Your Majesty, comes to our attention that Rune joins us tonight celebrating our 9th birthday! Happy birthday to Rune. From where are you, my lord? What state? He's also from North Carolina! What time is this tonight, Your Majesty? Whenever you're ready, this is Rune. So, Rune, congratulations to you, my lord, and we wish you a very happy 9th birthday. Another cheer for Rune.
What do you think of the experience here so far on this particular trip?
It's been really good. It was easy to get inside, and we got to pick our own night. Sometimes they let you pick, and we got red and yellow. So those of you who know me know why I picked red and yellow. Go Kai Mega. Anyway, for the castle itself, I love it. We've been to 2 other ones, and this is our favorite.
Yeah. We've been to the one in Kissimmee and also the one in Atlanta. and this is definitely the better of the three. I really thought the one in Kissimmee would have been better than it was, but it just was showing its age, I thought, in a lot of ways. The castle here is great, though. We did notice that a new addition to the King's Tavern appears to be the flat screens that are on the walls here, which they'll tell you that they don't have any type of cutlery in the medieval times, but yet they have flat screens on the walls. So there's that for you. What's some of your favorite things about coming here? What do you enjoy the most about coming here, for example?
My favorite thing is just the show in general. I think it's a good live action show, and it's really funny because the knights have their own personalities, and it shows whenever they're fighting in the ring.
Yep. Well, we've been coming to this show long enough to where we've seen three or four different versions of the story, and they're up to one now that it's probably the best of the ones that they've done in terms of production value. So what did we purchased something on the way in. We're going to be a little coy here. This is one of the things that I always tell people about coming here, is that it can be a little expensive, but we purchased something from the King's Tavern.
I always purchase a drink when I get here. Sometimes it's a fruity drink. Sometimes it's just a regular, like, Coke or whatever. This time I got a fruity drink because I like the whipped cream and the cherry on top.
Yep. And how much were our two beverages here?
$23.
Yeah. And it technically is a collector's cup, but
we already have a few at home.
Yeah, we do. We got several of these, but $23 there for two beverages. And that's on top of what we would have paid. Normally it would have been about $100 for the two of us for tickets, so that gives you an idea of what you're talking about already technically in terms of buying stuff. Plus you can see all the various gimmicks over there that can be bought as well. So there's a lot of stuff in here that you could spend money on. But we're about, I'd say 45 minutes or so away from showtime. So we may do a little bit more browsing around here, but for the time being, we're going to sit back, relax, and enjoy our
people watch
there as well, and enjoy our beverages.
Welcome! Thank you. I think you're all ready. Thank you for this. My lord and ladies, I am Sir David of Macedonia, Lord High Chancellor of tonight's sermon. By the grace of God Almighty, Privy High Chamberlain to His Majesty, I am your humble master of ceremonies for tonight's festivities, and I come before you at this time with a few very simple questions. By the sound of your voices, how many of you are joining us for the very first time? Until then, my friends, I think you'll be happy to know the King's Royal Bars will stay open all night long! Yeah. Well, don't you remember small supposed to be in the Battle of Bars here, so
insider tip, line up after everybody else is going in. Do not stand in front of the gates until it's time for you to be called. Otherwise, you look like a doofus.
Now, the Lord's ladies, I'm
going to
tell you something.
That might be pretty close to full here, Zane.
Table.
Thank you.
Champions in the realm, and this night your skills will be put to the test. I have arranged some entertainment for my guests and a chance for you to display your prowess in horsemanship. I pray you seek out my master of horse and prepare.
My lords, my ladies, raise a cheer for the knights of the bell! And
Now one of the most difficult, dramatic, and dangerous of battlefield maneuvers. By knights to return attack from the rear. Once again, my lord, we pray you.
Can he drink from the bar?
The Patrio! Poised for flight has come for fully, but once the hood has been removed, the age-old dance of hunted and hunter begins. Behold,
the sport of kings!
on foot.
Thank you.
Darn you to heck. So close. Just got finished with our Medieval Times experience here. We were both sitting on the edge of our seats because for the first time, I think, in forever, when we've picked out a night we wanted to cheer for, which tonight we were cheering for the Red and Yellow Night, we were in the final two, and that stupid Black and White Night had to come in and ruin everything.
We were close. We were so close. So close.
I think at some point in time, we might see a knight who wins and be cheering in his section, but not tonight. So, good experience all around here, though. It's as you can see out the front window here. It's raining now, not profusely, but it is raining a little bit. Had a good experience overall, though. Food was great.
As always.
The show I thought was very good here this evening. Sometimes we've been here and it kind of seemed like they were almost phoning it in a little bit, like they don't always seem to be hitting each other as hard as they could be, I guess you could say. But here this evening, it was good all the way around. Yeah, that's my wife there. I'll turn the camera on myself here just to be fair, because
I'm not talking.
Well, we're both talking. But
there we go.
Yeah, that works a little bit better. But show was great. Food was great. Yeah, food's always good here, though. Jill mentioned earlier that she thought if they would just give us a bigger bowl of soup and maybe two pieces of bread, we could just have that for our meal.
Be good to go.
And you made a promise to her in the show there, too. You're going to try and find a recipe for that soup.
Yes, tomato bisque. If you got a tomato bisque recipe, send it to me.
Yep, it's good stuff. All totaled, I'd say, how much money did we spend here this evening? $70 or so?
Roughly, yeah.
Between our drink and my ticket, which her ticket was free, you're talking $70.
Happy birthday to me.
Exactly. That's the reason why we're here. But it's a great experience, though. This is, to us, better than Pirates Voyage, which replaced Dixie Stampede. We both wish Dixie Stampede would have stayed. Battery's down on this camera here. So we're going to go ahead and wrap it up. But
come to Medieval Times. It is fabulous. It's wonderful.
Myrtle Beach Castle is better than Atlanta and better than Kissimmee.
We are going to try Maryland and Illinois and Dallas one day. Yeah. Those are the three we know we can get to.
I think we can call that a castle conquest of sorts. But this is us, Rob and Jill, tripping with Truesdales or tripping Truesdales. That's our new hashtag. So, that said, everybody come to Medieval Times. Have a good time.
Bye.
See y'all later.